Hi, this is Ken Pyle with VOD TV. We're at the Connections Conference, and we just heard from one of the keynote speakers, Glenn Lurie of AT&T. You're the president of the emerging device. Yeah. That's right. So really, all the new technologies and devices that are kind of propelling new connections. You showed some spectacular growth rate from 2.5 years ago when you started. If you could talk a little bit about the types of devices you're seeing there.
Yeah, I mean, our focus is take smartphones out and regular voice phones, anything else you wirelessly enable. So anything from your car, your computer, your tablet, your e-reader, your connected healthcare device, all of that's what my team focuses on. And we're looking to wirelessly enable everything.
Yeah, and in your slides, you showed, I counted 11 verticals, and you really said that's just a subset of what's out there.
Yeah, I think what we found in the last couple of years is each vertical is very different. What we have to do is get inside the ecosystem of those verticals. So if you pick computing and you think about all the people in the world that make a computer, who are their key customers, so whether that's software players, whether that's obviously wireless module players, all of that ecosystem, distribution, we've got to get into each vertical and really be a part of that vertical. And that's the way we've structured the emerging device group and what we've gone out and done. And we've had great success in really going in and showing them how the device is better once wirelessly enabled. It's smarter.
Well, and there's also the business aspect of it. You're not talking about buckets of minutes necessarily, but you're talking about whole different models, aren't you?
Yeah, we're talking about every model under the sun. So we've actually kind of gone at this from a clean sheet of paper. Like, let's walk into a partner, let's sit down together, let's figure out what you're trying to do, what I'm trying to do, and we've done all kinds of crazy deals. My CFO runs when he sees me coming. And the reason is that they're all different, right? You know, the activation processes, this is not about the smartphone world we've come from. We love smartphones, right? Our customers love them, but at the same time, this is a new business. And so what we've tried to do is look at wholesale models, retail models, rev share models that make sense for both our partners, and really more importantly, make sense for the customer, and they're gonna get something they want.
Well, and the example you gave, of course, the kind of the famous example is the Kindle, yeah, and the It's Magic comment.
It's incredible. I mean, give Amazon all the credit in the world. You know, they came out with this device that they wanted to replace a book, and they wanted customers to be able to get content anytime, anywhere. So you wirelessly enabled it. Great, great plan. But they didn't want to confuse the customer with the whole wireless rate plans, so they bundled inside of the book the cost of transport. So I sell them, you know, bits and bytes. They're a wholesale partner. And then they go and they built this wonderful consumer experience. And it's working. I mean, they can't keep them in stock, and customers love the experience. And we've learned from that, and we try to take that kind of open thought process to all kinds of other devices.
Well, and it probably is a kind of a pointer for where things are going in the retail space, yeah, as you add wireless.
Well, absolutely. Well, the thing we have to do better is make it simple, mm-hmm, right? You know, when you go buy a Kindle, you don't sit and activate it for 30 minutes, right? You go home, it's working off the shelf. You start reading, you start buying things, you set your account up. I think the iPad 2 is another phenomenal example, right? You buy the iPad, you take it, we call it stack them high, watch them fly, right? You just take it and you go home, and you get to decide on that screen and have a relationship with AT&T on the screen. You don't have to call us. You can activate when you want. You can stop the plan when you want, because it's a prepaid plan. And we've tried to give customers the ultimate flexibility.
So from a retail perspective, it seems like in making devices smarter and making devices connected, it's going to really change the face of retail as you move forward.
It has to, right? Because theoretically, if you make it harder, right? Think about, we used to always hear, I've been in the wireless business 21 years, right? We used to always hear about, gosh, I dread going and buy. It's such a hard decisions, and you have to pick rate plans and sign contracts. We got to make it different. Mm-hmm. We got to make it frictionless is a word we like to use, where the customer comes in like they do today, they buy that device, and they can have that device do the things it needs to do while connected. And so we're looking all the time. We're working with Best Buy, Walmart, Radio Shack, with them to say, how do we do this better? We're working with our OEM partners. So this is all about building a brand new business.
Well, and switching a little bit, one of the other verticals was telehealth and the glow cap.
The glow cap is I think fundamentally one of the coolest things, because it's so simple, yeah, right? All it really does is remind you to take your medication. But then when you really start thinking about adherence in the U.S., and I gave some stats, right? 47% of Americans over 50 don't take their medication correctly, which then drives what? Visits to the doctor, more insurance payments. It really drives, it's $100 billion issue. What this device allows you to do is get reminded to take your medication. It shows you the adherence. You can see your adherence. My doctor can see my adherence. My mom and dad can see if I'm taking my pills if I'm at college, right, for example, or me with my parents who just retired. It allows you to get that social networking part of this thing and remind that customer. It also reminds you in the home. Glow cap lights up, it has an audible, it reminds you to do the right thing, and you can set it up to take medications multiple times a day. It's a wonderful concept of simply helping people adhere to what they're supposed to do.
And from a business model perspective, it sounds like you actually bring in some of the players within the ecosystem.
Right. Yeah. Well, I think when we first built the group, we thought we would be a part of the ecosystem. What we really didn't realize is that we ended up kind of being the sun, right? We ended up kind of being the one bringing in all the players. And it's really worked out well. You know, my team's philosophies are simple. We are here to try to grow an incremental business. We're here to be great partners to the ecosystem. One of the things I joke around about is just no one that calls us, we don't call back. So we get calls. I mean, we're AT&T, right? We're this new group and we get calls from little players of one or two that are brand new little startups, and we talk to them all because there's great ideas out there and there's people in these ecosystems who need to be heard so we can try to get this innovation going faster.
Well, and you have a service, the Foundry service that Kurt mentioned.
Yeah, the Foundry are actually buildings. I mean, they are actually places where we're driving innovation. We're allowing people to come in, utilize all the knowledge we have from our labs, our networks, our systems, and bring in their ideas and together incubate and drive innovation, whether that's around applications, devices, around networks, it's the whole thing. And we've got one very close to where we're standing. Yeah, we launched one in Tel Aviv in Israel. We did that because of the innovation happening right now, especially around telecommunications is massive there. And so we're going to continue to build these foundries and grow and look at how we drive that innovation. It's really about the U.S. leading in innovation and continuing to lead.
Yeah, and it really is more than just apps that you're developing there. I mean, it is beyond that.
There's no rules. Yeah. It's everything, right? It's bring a great idea. It's hardware. It's software. It's applications. Again, you know, we are theoretically a networks company. It's around our networks and the technology around those types of things. So it is a phenomenal thing that John Donovan, our CTO, has brought to the company and executed on, and I'm very excited about it.
Well, so one of the things that it's going to drive is a lot more penetration of devices, and you're saying at 107% penetration, that's not enough in a couple of years.
Well, I mean, look, we're going to be at 98% penetration here shortly. I think we're at 96 plus right now. The quarter just ended, is almost ended. So we need to look at the next great growth area, and it's going to be around connecting these other things. And I do see 300, 400, 500% penetration. We're going to pass that because as we go and as we kind of get the ecosystems excited and they are about driving this, we're just going to continue to see more and more devices that are smart and connected and give those customers a great customer experience.
Well, super. And I know Kurt will be here to hold you to your predictions
Absolutely.
In a couple of years.
I'll come back. I've been loved.
Excellent. Well, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thanks.